All right, so this tutorial is for the Managerial Accounting Section 401 course. This is the lecture course that begins on Tuesday, January 21st. So I am setting up this tutorial to help you that before the class actually begins, that you can actually read through all the different links I've set up for you in Blackboard, and also to help you get registered with my accounting lab before the course even begins. So to start is first, once you log into Blackboard for the course, or you see section 401, you'll be directed right here to the home page, which I've got the Blackboard tutorial, which you're now listening to, and also the My Accounting Lab registration instructions. I've got a welcome for you, again telling you the class does begin on Tuesday, January 21st, and also to make sure that you do get registered with My Accounting Lab. I've got the purpose and overview of the course, some policies on netiquette policy, some technology requirements, and also some minimum technical skills. If you do have any questions about any of this stuff, do email me. All right, and which I will give you in a second. I'll show you where all my email and contact information is. All right, the next link I have is the announcement link. And again, notice this is the link. I will actually send this through your student emails. And if you get this, you'll essentially say the site's now available, and you should review all these different links, and also to get registered with My Accounting Lab, and also to remind you that the course does begin on Tuesday, January 21st. All right, so again, under announcements, I will use those weekly. And of course, since this is a ground face-to-face course, you know, just come to class. I also will give you all these instructions in class as well. All right, my instructor, just to give you an introduction, here's some background information about me. Here's a picture of me. Here's my name, David Giriga, my office phone, email, office location. I'm F324. And I know this is a ground course, and we'll go over my campus-based office hours, but I also have virtual hours as well on Tuesday, Thursday from 3 to 5. Again, that's under my instructor. All right, next up is the syllabus and class schedule. So again, what you'll do is I'm just going to open this up real quick. This is all the standard stuff you get in any of the courses you take at St. Louis Community College. And you'll notice once this does open up, again, you'll see that this is for section 401. I've got the meeting days and times. This is a Tuesday, Thursday class that meets at 9:30 to 10:45 in room F329. There's my name, my office hours, my virtual hours. This is, you know, location. We're on the Forest Park campus. Again, my email, office location is F324, my office phone. And also that just tell you the probably the best way to get a hold of me is through emails. All right, course descriptions listed. I've got all the course prerequisites, the course learning outcomes. Again, here's the required textbook. You do need to get the My Accounting Lab with eText. Get that either through the campus bookstore, or you can also buy it directly from Pearson. Here's the ISBN. I've got the technology requirements, classroom policies. Again, there's going to be three exams. Here's the breakdown. 55% of your grade is exams. I've got several quizzes. I believe there's going to be 11. I only count 10, so 100 points of quizzes, 100 points of homeworks. Those are each weighted the same note. And then, of course, you have a project that's weighted at 9%. All right, so again, the exams are proctored on campus in our classroom. And again, I'll give you the exam dates when we get there. I'll give you all these instructions in class as well. On the quizzes and the homeworks, that's the one thing about this course. You do take those through My Accounting Lab, so that's why you do need to get that access code. On the quizzes, I give you two attempts on the quizzes. I count the best attempt. Just make sure you get those in by the due dates, which I will remind you daily when we meet each, you know, during our class meetings. And finally, you do get 11 quizzes. I think I mentioned this earlier. I do drop your lowest quiz at the end of the semester. Very similar to homeworks. You do those through My Accounting Lab. I do give you unlimited attempts on the homework. Just make sure, again, you get those in by the due dates, because your points do add up, and it would hurt you if you don't get those submitted. But that's the difference, is the quizzes you get two attempts, and the homeworks you get unlimited attempts. All right, project, you'll get that once we get about the midpoint of the semester. I've got that listed in the course outline, and of course I'll talk in class about that as well. And of course, that's going to be worth 50 points, or about 9% of your overall grade. On attendance, you do need to come to class regularly. In fact, if you don't attend class within the first 2 weeks, they do purge you from the course, and I do track this. I have to by law. We use an attendance tracker, so read the attendance policy and make sure you do come to class regularly. All right, last thing, I'll just kind of page down. I do have the course outline in terms of the pace of the course. Note the dates, what chapters we're covering. This gives you the pace. Notice that the first exam is the week of February 17th. And as I keep going down, notice the projects are available March 2nd. Exam two is March 30th, that week. And then the final exam is the week of May 11th. So again, read through all this. This is to kind of give you a pace, to kind of give you an idea of what to expect each week. All right. So again, let me close that down. So again, this is under syllabus and class schedule. The class schedule is what I just showed you. That's also included in the syllabus. Here is the textbook information, my calendar with eText, ISBN. It's a Pearson product. If you have any questions about how to get this book or you have a difficulty, please let me know. All right. Course readiness agreement. I do the same thing for my online courses. If you read through all this, you get all the material, you're ready to go by January 21st, which is a Tuesday. You click this agreement and you get 5 bonus points before the class even begins. That's pretty good. So do that. That's under course readiness agreement. Now, learning modules. This is a supplement to what we do in class. So if you happen to miss a course or miss a class, you can just click the chapter we're on. I'll just click chapter 2. And this has all the different things you should be doing. Of course, we do this a lot of the stuff in class as well. But if you happen to miss a lecture or whatever, I've got all my lectures recorded. I've got homework illustrations. I've got textbook illustrations all in these folders. I give essentially you everything I give to my online course, I'm giving to you. And I found last semester, some of my students sometimes, if they missed it, they were sick or they had to miss a class and they were worried about getting caught up, they would just go into these learning modules and click a file, and that would help them get caught up, and that way it didn't hurt them as much. So again, I've got all these under learning modules. These are optional, these are supplements, but I'm giving you extra information to try to increase your success in this course. All right, everything else, I got a PowerPoint link here. If you want to look at my PowerPoints directly, you can do that. I've got ebook solutions. These are all the solutions for the end of chapter exercises. Again, this is the practice stuff. I don't collect these, this is learning. I've got that. And then I also have a link on here for check your grades. All right, so last couple things. Again, this is the lecture course of managerial accounting. It begins Tuesday, January 21st. Here's my email, djeriga@stlcc.edu. Email me, let me know if you have any problems or questions. Try to get registered with my accounting lab on or before Tuesday, January 21st. There is a 14-day free trial period. So if you're gonna go that route, I would suggest you wait till about the 20th of January to get registered, because once you do that, the time starts to count against you. So you might wanna wait till a little bit later to get into that if you go the free 2-week route first. But after 14 days, they do require you to buy it. So my point is you should all be able to get registered from day one, and that way you get off to a good start. All right, so again, welcome to the course. I look forward to meeting everybody. And again, see you guys on Tuesday, January 21st.